Hello, everybody. My name is Scott Chacon. Thanks for having me. I did want to talk a little bit today about databases. I find databases really interesting in the software development lifecycle because they're something that we don't have a lot of developer tools for. I think, you know, I was one of the co-founders of GitHub. I spent a lot of time thinking about the development lifecycle and developer tools. And one thing that I've worked at in every company that I've worked at, including GitHub, is how difficult it is to work with databases in development. Most of the time, they go down one of a couple of different routes. Either we do seed data, which I can kind of demo real quickly. So if you know, I was working on a Prisma project, for example, in Redwood, I would reset the database, you know, or I'd start up a new one and I'd run a seed on it, and I would say, okay, great. And then the problem with this is that it's very, very difficult to keep this close to production, to keep it close to what you the data you really want to do. It's impossible to debug problems. It's usually a minimal set of data, so you're not dealing with a lot of performance issues, and it's very hard to keep up to date. So I don't think I've ever spent any significant amount of time on a team that could keep that up to date in a realistic manner and have data that was really valuable for people to work with. On the other hand, you can download a copy of a production database, which has happened in every company I've worked at, including GitHub, and run it on a local developer laptop. And that's bad for lots of reasons too, right? It's really big. It's really slow. In a lot of cases, you can debug data, but you have personal identifiable information on everybody's laptop, and that's really not ideal. One of the things that we're trying to solve, me and Peter Pistorius, who's one of the core developers on Redwood, is to help make working with development data a little bit easier. And so we're doing that with a project that we're calling Snaplet. And so what I want to show you here is sort of an example of what that might look like. So I did a quick demo of just kind of something that normal people would run into when working on something. So if I've seeded my database and I run my Redwood project here, you can see I have a couple of customers in this sort of video rental thing. It's really beautiful. I think everybody can appreciate the beautiful design that went into this, mostly on my part here. But we can see we have this development snapshot. Everything looks fine. You know, the video is returned. If we actually go to production, so here's our production. Somebody's told us this problem that this person is both returned and not returned. How does that work, right? And it's really difficult to figure that out because I can't. You know, you can shell in somewhere and run SQL commands and try to figure out what does the data look like. You can actually look directly at the database, but actually to debug this is difficult. And I think everybody's really run into a problem like this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to demo what Snaplet looks like. So Snaplet, essentially what Snaplet does is you connect to your database. We will pull it down. We'll clean any information that we need, and then you can get a copy of that. We make a snapshot of that every day, and you can pull down a cleaned sort of version of that database and load it into your development environment and use that in a way that is easy and fast and not dangerous. And so if I here type snaplet restore, what it will do is pull down a snapshot of the development or of the cleaned version of the production database and restore it locally so that I can work on it in a safe manner. And so I'm going to back up my database that I was working on. So I have a copy of it that I can go back to. And it says that it restored the snapshot. So now if we go to production, before we didn't really have, we only had a handful of customers. Now we have essentially all of the customers that we have in production, except they've all been anonymized. And so I can actually take this same customer ID that we have in production, and now I can pull it up here. And you can see also that instead of Scott Chacon with my email address, don't email me, I'm just kidding, you can email me. We have, you know, Betsy Hain with a completely made up faker email address, and we can go through in Snaplet and we can decide, you know, for any of these, what tables do we not want to include. If they're really big log tables, we don't have to pull them down, saving us some time and space. We can replace, we can say what are P2 sort of suggestions, and we can say replace the city with sort of faked cities and things like that in the next snapshot that we make. it will clean that data out. So I hope that you've enjoyed this presentation. I thank you for your time, and enjoy the rest of Prisma Day.